In this video, we are going to talk about sizes for your digital planner, why they matter, how to determine the digital planner size you should use, and what is the best digital planner dimensions or sizes so you can create the perfect digital planner for you or for your customers. If you are not a part of our digital planning family yet, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified whenever I publish a new video every week about all things digital planning, creativity, and productivity. So let's start. First, let's talk about why your digital planner dimensions and size matters. First, compatibility with your digital writing tools. The PDF annotating apps that we use, such as GoodNotes, has a fixed range of pen and highlighter sizes, and depending on the dimensions and sizes we have used in creating the digital planner or digital notebook, the minimum size of the digital writing tools, such as the pen tool and the highlighter tool, may look too small or too large. The same thing with the maximum size, it may appear too big or too small. The zooming capability will also be affected. If the size and dimensions are in the smaller size, the zooming capability will be limited. Comparing it to a digital planner with bigger dimensions, the zooming capability will be better. The second reason is storage space. The bigger the dimensions of your digital planner or digital notebook will affect their file sizes. And digital planners and digital notebooks are generally in the megabytes or MB file sizes, but as they accumulate, they will occupy larger and larger storage space. They may be small at first and you might not notice it if you have a large storage space, but if you have a limited or smaller storage space, every byte counts, right? And lastly, the loading speed. As I have mentioned, the bigger your dimensions, the bigger the file size will be. These are the file sizes of two Keynote files with the same elements. This is a simple design, so the loading speed is still fast, but imagine if we have digital notebooks with hundreds of pages, the loading speed will greatly decrease and you will experience the thing called lagging of the digital planner or digital notebook. So now, how can you determine the size and dimensions to use when creating digital planners and digital notebooks for yourself or for your customers? First, determine the screen resolution of the device where the digital planner or digital notebook will be used. For me, I am using the iPad Pro 2020 version in 12.9 inches and the screen resolution is 2048 by 2732 pixels. The second step, let's create a PDF file and I will be using the Keynote app. Let's enter the dimensions. Add minimal design so we can see whether we like the zooming capability of this one. Then duplicate the pages until you reach the average number of pages your final digital planner will be. Mine is around 50 just for this tutorial. Add some hyperlinks, then export the file. Now open the file in the PDF annotating app you are using. If you plan to sell your digital planners, I suggest that the app you should use is the one which most of your customers are using. Then test if you like the digital writing tools, and of course the zooming capability. Also, don't forget to check the loading speed of the pages when using the hyperlinks in your digital planner. If you are not satisfied with the performance of the digital planner or digital notebook that you just made, go back to step number 2 again and this time use a smaller size with the same ratio as the screen resolution. For example, I want smaller size, I will divide the dimensions with 2 and I will then use 1024 for the height and 1366 as the width. Then repeat steps 2 and 3 again. You can do this process as many times as you want. So now what then is the best size or dimensions for your digital planner and digital notebook? The best size and dimensions will be the one that will enable and encourage you and your customers to use and have fun and be creative in the digital planner or digital notebook. But if you follow the guide I shared to you, you will definitely find the perfect size and dimensions in no time. Share your planner dimensions and sizes in the comment section below so we can try them all and make the testing process faster, and maybe give some feedback if you have used the dimensions and sizes mentioned. This is Keizle, and until next time, bye!